Can you tell us what it's like there, right there on the ground?
The wildfire is extremely smoky, and the visibility on 995 is extremely impaired. You go through basically a cloud of smoke, a thick cloud of smoke. But we're very fortunate. We have firefighters from Indian River County Fire Rescue and St. Lucie County Fire District who are able to get on either side of 95 to make sure that the flames are extinguished. We also have bulldozers from the Florida Forest Service and a helicopter from the Florida Forest Service doing everything they can to stop the spread of the fire and so we can reopen all lanes of I-95.
Now, Melissa, we understand this is a 45-acre fire. How much of the fire have crews been able to contain at this point?
It grew about another 5 acres. It's about 50 acres, and it's 40% contained. Thanks to the great quick response by both St. Lucie and Indian River County Fire, they were able to stop the spotting. The high winds were spreading the fire, trying to get across I-95, bringing leaves, sticks, and twigs across I-95, but the quick response by fire rescue, both St. Lucie and Indian River, quickly contained that fire on the east side of I-95.
Melissa, how close are the flames, the actual flames, to I-95? And at any point, have the flames jumped the highway?
The fire was trying to spread across I-95, but the fire was actually right up to the grass line of I-95. And firefighters were actually fighting it right off the side of I-95.
And we understand no homes or businesses are threatened at this point. Is that correct?
No homes or businesses. There are power lines and there are gas lines. And if the fire did spread across I-95, there is a prison and there are unoccupied homes over there. So that's why we're doing everything we can to stop the spread of this fire. But the wind and the weather is not working with us. And it was kind of an uphill battle, but we're doing everything we can.
I know you were in the middle of the fire itself. What do we know about people who are on the highway? Obviously, some people haven't been able to move. I know they're trying to get them off the road. Are there still people who are stuck on the road, as far as you know, because that smoke is blowing across?
I have now just got off at I-95 and Indrio. It's on the impasse of I-95 and Indrio Boulevard, and it is backed up as far as I can see. But FHP and the St. Lucie County Sheriff, plus Indian River County Sheriff, are doing everything they can to move the traffic along. And we're doing everything we can to reopen I-95, but you have to understand the smoke and visibility is extremely poor conditions. And also, firefighter safety, we're fighting this fire right off I-95.
Melissa, any reports at this point of car accidents or any kind of incidents like that because of the severe visibility issues?
I have not heard of any. I will ask around, but I have not heard of any accidents at this point. We're asking people, if they are in this traffic, please drive safely and carefully and do the best you can to get to your location safely.
All right, and Melissa, before we let you go, really quickly, just to reiterate, about 40% of this fire is contained, has burned about 45 acres. And what's the prognosis from here? What are the firefighters telling you, the Division of Forestry, about when they might be able to get this under control?
The weather is not cooperating with us. So it's taken minute by minute, and we're doing everything we can to contain this fire. So firefighters are using water, you're using bulldozers, we're using helicopters. We're going to do everything we can, bringing in crews from Orlando, Okeechobee, St. Lucie, Indian River County, to do everything we can to stop this fire. And we're just asking residents to have patience with us. We're doing the best we can.
All right, Melissa Yunas from the Division of Forestry, thank you. You're talking about those crews. We are looking at a lot of video that is just coming into our newsroom of those crews fighting the fire. This is up close. Our photojournalist Greg Duncan was there on the scene. And just like Melissa said, look at how close it is to the interstate. This is what she was talking about and why there is such severe visibility issues. Mike, one of the things, we're going to bring in Mike Lyons now, that Melissa...